Revolutionizing the way people treat people in business. The Experience Pros, America's home for positive business talk.
Welcome back to the Experience Pros Radio Show. This is America's home for positive business talk. Got you two in the background digging that, that's for sure. And Kyle Cook hanging out, CrossFit South Denver, hanging out in place of Angel Tussie today. Thank you for being here, man.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for having me once again.
You know, it's a good thing. And like I said, time flies when you're having fun. And we have had such a great time chatting with you.
Yeah, it's been great to be on here.
Once again, for people who are just tuning in and they want to get their fitness on, they want to do something with somebody that they know, like, and trust. And yeah, after 45 minutes of listening to you, they're like, dude, I'm all in. How do they contact you?
Preferably call me 303-725-6989. If you're skittish on the phone, so am I. Don't worry sometimes. Kyle@CrossFitSouthDenver.com.
Kyle@CrossFitSouthDenver.com. And give that phone number a little slower.
It's 303-725-6989.
There you go. Kyle, you know, here on the program, we talk a lot about influencer. The influencer effect. I actually just today got done recording or producing our next training, which is called How to Become a Media Magnet.
Okay.
And we talk about, if you're going to become a media magnet, you have to build up an influencer effect. You have to you know, it's a catch 22. The media is not going to be interested in you unless they know what you've done.
Yeah.
You're not going to do anything until people are interested in you. So yeah, that catch 22. Well, let's talk a little bit about influencers. During the commercial break, you were saying that there used to be and still is to some degree, a stigma on what influencers are. Give me your description of how you felt about influence.
Yeah. My assumption was that you needed to be in the game or in your particular field for about 15 years before you spoke up.
Right.
Just to give those that had been around a little bit longer, you know, the benefit of the doubt that they probably knew a little bit more than you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And that's still true to a degree. Keep in mind, when we're talking about influence, we're not talking about arrogance.
No.
And there should be no pride. And if there is pride at the door, leave it at the door as you go into a scenario where, I always tell people I am not the brightest bulb in the knife drawer.
Yeah.
I don't know everything that there is to know about anything. But I know a thing or two, and what I know, yeah, if it's of value to you, I will share with you. Angel and I started noticing about 9 months ago that all the talking heads, and you mentioned one that maybe you follow, Gary V.
Yeah.
For those of you who don't know, Gary Vaynerchuk, is one of America's leading influencers and for good or bad, I would say he is, right? Yeah. And you either love him or you hate him, and it doesn't matter because you know him, right?
Right.
He's an influencer.
Yes.
And you know him. And in the situation with people like Gary, I would never go in and say I can do what Gary does any different or better, or I could do it differently, but I couldn't do it better than what Gary does. Gary, yeah, does what he does really well because he's the best Gary V that there is.
Yeah.
The flip side of that, though, is even Gary V, along with Adweek and Forbes magazine and Inc. magazine and Mari Smith on Facebook and Seth Oberlin and so many others, are all started 9 months ago, started giving weight and credence to the rise of the micro influencer. And they describe that person or those people as being authentic people who have a following of 1,000 to 10,000 people who can sway opinion with their suggestion.
Yeah.
And along those lines, if all these talking heads are talking about becoming a micro influencer, then I think it behooves us to want to do that. And we go back to the saying, maybe you're familiar with this. You're probably familiar with the phrase, maybe not with the attribution. It's a friend of ours named Bob Berg, who wrote the Go Giver, the Go Giver series of books, that are New York Times bestselling, books. But he says, all things being equal, people do business with people that they know, like, and trust, right?
Yeah.
And that, I think, is the very essence. It's the skeletal remains. It's the skeletal structure that holds up this influencer effect that I'm talking about.
Yeah, I've seen it all through my life growing up on the people that I pick up on, how they've influenced me. They start with a group of maybe 700 views on YouTube, and the next thing you know, they are, because they're giving their information away for free, they are the next big thing in their particular field. One name comes to mind. His name's Kelly Starrett. Guy about 5 years ago, nobody knew his name.
Yeah.
The other day, so I got to meet Obama and take Obama through a little workout routine. So it's giving it away for free, telling people how to stay healthy is a good way to become a micro influencer.
It is a good way, and there are many different roads, right? That get us to accomplish that. One thing is for sure: you can't become a micro influencer by calling yourself one. An actual influencer has to call you one. Has to, in fact, a series of them.
That's unfortunate,
right? you'll know if you have a following by stopping and looking around, and if you do have a following. It'll become evident. I was sharing with another person on the show earlier this week. We've been focusing on this message for months now. And as we've been focusing on the message, and I've been making slight adjustments, not pendulum swings, to our, various socials and whatnot. I spent a little time on Twitter earlier this week, and the response to it was, I got a new follower every minute for days. Wow. And right,
that doesn't happen often,
but it does happen if people are following and if they want to be engaged and if the content is consistent enough and quality enough.
Consistency,
right?
That's
and the same huge. thing with working out, right?
Yeah. You can't come twice a week. You can, but sometimes you don't get what you want
I'm picking up what you're laying down there, brother. Hey, listen, time flies and we have to wrap our program. But before we do, CrossFit South Denver is the website.
Yes, sir.
Kyle at CrossFit South Denver is the email address and the phone number one more time.
303-725-6989.
Folks, let me just tell you this. I've known this man for a whole whopping hour, but I can tell you this. I want to get to know him better. And I think you do too. Go check out Kyle Cook at CrossFit South Denver and get your fitness on. And if you're saying, well, I'm in Washington, D.C. or Fresno, California or Houston, Texas, that's all right. The phone still works and he probably has a good referral for you. Thanks for tuning in to this, the Home of Positive Business Talk. This is the Experience Pros Radio Network. More hour number two after this news.